David from Figma here. In this video, I'll show you how to use frames in Figma Design to take your projects to the next level. But first, let's talk about what Figma Design is all about. Have you ever wondered how websites, apps, or even digital experiences come to life? That's where Figma Design comes in. It's the ultimate tool for creators, giving you the power to bring ideas to life, collaborate with others in real time, and build something truly amazing. Whether you're crafting an illustration for a class project, creating an animation to bring a concept to life, or designing a mobile app for a school club, Figma Design makes it easy for anyone, not just designers, to jump in, explore, and create. With that, let me explain Figma Design's basic layout and features.
Here we are in Figma Design's editor, and at the center is the canvas. This is where you visualize and arrange everything you add to your design. You can place shapes, text, images, and more, and adjust them freely. On the left side, we have the Layers panel. Everything on the canvas is represented here in a stacked list. Selecting an item in the Layers panel highlights it on the canvas, making it easy to organize and navigate through different elements in your design. On the right, we have the Design panel, where you can freely modify properties of any selected object. If I select a shape, I can adjust its color, size, position, and more. This panel is key to customizing your design elements. And lastly, at the bottom, you'll find the toolbar, which includes essential tools like shapes, text, and frames. And that's the basic layout of Figma.
So with that, let's go ahead and learn how frames can take your design to the next level. Now, you saw an example of an illustration, a prototype, and an animation earlier in this video. All of those designs were made possible and efficient using frames in Figma Design. What we're going to do is walk through a couple different pages of activities to get you familiar with frames. Go ahead and go over to page one. You can pause this video at any time and work at your own pace. Let's start learning how to use frames by first, adding our first frame to the canvas. Using the pinch gestures on your trackpad or holding the Command or Control key while scrolling on your mouse, let's zoom into this first area of the canvas. And let's add our first frame by either clicking on the Tools panel here or the F key. Simply drag your cursor to make the size of the frame that you'd like. If you would like to change those dimensions, you can always go over to the panel on the right here. I can change my dimensions to be 500 by, let's say, 500 to make that perfect square. Now, this is covering the elements I want to edit, so I'm actually going to click the frame and move it, which is pretty nice. I can even double-click this frame and title it. Let's call this one Duck Pond. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start dragging elements from these shapes into the frame itself. You'll see that frame becomes blue, letting me know that that is now inside of the frame. I can further look at this by clicking the Layers panel. You can see I have a lot of layers, so organizing things in frames is really going to help me when I design things, especially with lots on the canvas. Let's left-click and bring this in here. You can see it's also in the frame. Let's grab the feet, bring those in as well. Let's grab the wing. I'll edit this in a second. And let's grab the bill. Oh, and that's not really looking how I want it to. Let's zoom in here and see if we can fix this design. I'm going to go in and zoom over to the pond right here, and I can see the bill is actually the first layer in this frame. I'm going to select the bill and bring it below the head, and that's looking a lot better. I also can select anything in the layers panel, like the foot one or foot two, or hold down shift to select multiple items and drag them below the body, and I can even edit them here. Now, I want to change the wing. If I have a ton of layers inside of a frame, I can actually just select the frame itself, I can just select the item I want to edit. It will then appear on the canvas as highlighted, and I can tilt that however I'd like. This is looking pretty good. Let's go a little bit further and click on Duck Pond, click on the frame, and now click on Fill in the Designs panel. Let's change this to be a light blue to kind of go with our Duck Pond theme. That's looking pretty good, and I'm very happy with that. Now, if I want this to be any larger, or if I want to move it around the canvas, I can click here. If I want this design to be smaller or larger, and I try to change the size of the frame, you can change the size of the frame, but it's not going to change the design. The frame is kind of like a container or a window or a pond in which your designs are in. If I want to actually scale this, I can hit the K key on my keyboard. I can scale this down or scale this up however I'd like. Hit the Escape key to then get back to your selection tool. Let's move over to these three images to see what frames can also do for us when working with elements on the canvas. What we're going to do is wrap these three images in a frame. Hit the F key and just drag over all of them. Then what I'm going to do is hold down shift, select all of them, make them center and center. Looking pretty good. Now what I want is I'm going to add some constraints to these images. Select the frame, make sure you're in frame one, Then I'm going to hold down shift on all of these again. And what you can see is if I were to make this a little bit larger, a little bit smaller, or move it around, it's going to keep everything in the top left. You can see when I hold down shift and select these, top left constraints over on the right-hand panel are selected. If I were to go ahead, and I encourage you to do this, is select them to be center and center, this is going to change the behavior of those shapes in the frame. When I contract or expand the dimensions of my frame, those will always stay in the center. So this is nice if I'm going and making a banner for a website or making a specific size of a image. I don't have to go and select the specific images and move them around. All I have to do is set my constraints and then move the frame size. If you ever find that maybe there's a constraint behaving a little bit differently, like if I move these around and you can see that that duck on the right's behaving not that I want to, go ahead and click on those elements, look in the right-hand panel and see how your constraints are set. The last example in this page is going to be talking about auto layout with frames. Now there's a ton you can learn about auto layout. This is just a quick overview. I'm gonna hit the F key on my keyboard and I'm going to left click and drag over all of these potential book titles. Now what I'm going to do is I'm gonna select frame 2 and I'm going to go over here in the right panel and select auto layout. What that's going to do is create some boundaries. You can see I can actually make the spacing between the titles a little bit different. I can go ahead and change how this padding on the top is changed. I'm gonna hit Control Z and edit that. What's also nice, if I change the dimensions, where maybe I want this to fit into an iPhone frame or be a little bit larger, it's going to change and contract those text elements. This again is just a very quick preview into what auto layout is. There's a ton you can do here, but do know that you can apply an auto layout to your frames so that the spacing and padding is consistent. With that, let's go ahead and click on page 2, frames and prototypes. On this page, if you zoom out, you'll see I have some pretty big frames. Now, what's cool about this is these frames are the actual viewport size of these devices. If I hit the F key again, and I see that on the right panel, I have different frame options, like phone and tablet, you can design in Figma Design within the exact dimensions of how that would be seen on the screen you're designing for. To show this, let's go ahead and hit the iPad frame and make sure you're in prototype mode up here on the right. Then go to Show Prototype Settings. I'm most likely going to have no device selected, so click on here and go ahead and scroll down to iPad Pro 11. Once here, select the frame you'd like, hit Shift Space, and you can see I can now scroll down on this frame because it is longer than the actual device and it feels like an actual app. I can click on this frame to the right and I can see it, but it's actually looking a little weird because it's not designed for the iPad. What I can do here is go back to my prototype settings, click on Show Prototype Settings, select the frame that I'd like to see, scroll up, and for this one, select iPhone 15, let's go Pro. Here I can go ahead and see this as if it were an actual app made for my school's skate club. This last one is designed for an Apple Watch. I'm not going to show you. It looks weird because this is previewing on an iPhone, but you'll go into prototype settings and go ahead and find that 44 millimeter Apple Watch to preview. That's how you can actually design in frames in Figma Design that are made for specific devices and view them as a prototype. How neat is that? Let's go over to grids and layouts and what you can use frames for when designing with these features. Here you'll see two iPhone 14/15 frames. Let's zoom in and let's go ahead and check this out. Now, when I click on this frame, I'm gonna go back to design view and I'm actually gonna scroll down and I'm gonna add a layout grid. What this is gonna do is help me see where things can be placed better, more strategically in the frame itself. This is gonna give you a 10 pixel grid because each square has, well, 10 pixels in it. This actually isn't what I want. I have 5 elements in my frame. Let's see if I can add a layout grid that's maybe 5 rows. Let's go to grid. Oh, let's add rows. It makes 5 right here. Awesome. Now what I can see is that it is evenly spaced within this frame, and I need to go ahead and tweak the design so that these elements fit a little bit better together. What this also does when you have layout grids is you can have your design snap to those grids themselves. You can see that red line snapping. I can click here, snap this up. There we go. I can click this, and let's snap that up there. You'll see that this looks, well, a lot better. You'll also see that things are a little off here. One thing you can do if things are selected in the frame is I can hold down shift and select all of my items, align them to center, and that's looking a lot better. Over here on the right, we're going to play a little bit with auto layout. Select the frame, go over to the panel here, and select auto layout. What that's going to allow you to do, again, is change the spacing. Now, what's really neat about this is if I drag an element, this basketball hoop that's outside of the frame, and bring it in, the auto layout is going to allow for this image to fit within the harmony of the preset auto layout. Let's go and snap it right under the surfer and look at that. If you zoom out though, you'll see that I'll need to actually make my frame a little bit larger to fit the design itself. Now in auto layout, I can select other elements, move them around, and I can design flawlessly and seamlessly in Figma Design's frame because that auto layout is applied. Again, there is so much you can do with auto layout. The presets here are pretty simple. But let's go ahead and check out the last activity, page 4, our first prototype. On this page, if you zoom out, you can see I have a massive frame, which I'm actually going to be dragging elements in to make my first prototype. Let's go ahead and just drag this first iOS status bar right here. You can see if I scroll down, I can go ahead and see that within the frame itself, iOS or iPhone 14, and bring that here. I'm going to be bringing in an image, and you'll see that it actually goes on top of or above the iOS status bar. So on the frames panel, I can go ahead and drag this right below. There we go. Another thing I can do, because I'm working in a frame, I can actually click, if I'm holding down shift, and I can move this image up or down, and it's not going to show that image outside the frame because when the frame is selected, I'm clipping the content, and I'm going to have that stay to be selected. Now I'm going to drag this text in here. This text is live, so if you want to call this club things, you're more than welcome to. Next thing I'm going to drag in is a frame. You can put frames inside of frames. If the frame has an auto layout applied, it will show as this little frame icon with auto layout. Let's snap this to the center here and snap to center there. Things are looking pretty good. I'm now going to drag in some cards, some events that are happening for clubs on campus. I'm going to drag this in the frame. You see that I can actually snap this to center here. I'm going to drag this other card in here. I can maybe just bring it to the left, snap to center, and that's looking pretty good. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to work within this footer frame here. And before I bring it into the larger frame, I'm going to click on this navigation bar. This is an auto layout applied here. And I'm going to drag it actually into another frame that already has auto layout applied and just snap it to the bottom. That's looking pretty good. Now let's bring this footer frame into the frame of our design here. And let's go ahead and hit the space bar, shift space, and see what this looks like. Make sure in prototype settings, you have the prototype settings selected to iPhone 14 or 15. I can scroll down and I can see this interacting as if it were an app. If I go ahead and move over to the canvas here, I can actually go back to design view. And if I want to change how maybe the background of my frame looks, you'll see that it's responding within the preview itself too. So any edit you make, let's say if I were to go ahead and actually change the date over here from March 22nd to let's say March 2nd, I want this to be actually 20 days ahead. When I scroll down here in my preview, you'll see that edit made. What's really nice about working in frames when you're previewing a prototype is you can quickly edit design. If you hit shift space and have the preview up, you don't have to go back and forth, toggle between tabs, and there's just so much you can do when designing in frames in Figma. And that wraps up this lesson on how to use frames in Figma design. Highly encourage you to go over here and maybe make another page, add some more frames of your choice, and continue designing freely on your own. Cheers.